In this video, I'll be explaining about the structure of antibody. As you can see, there is Y-shaped structure, right? And here there are two more structures available. Now, this Y-shaped structure is again, this whole structure is again divided into five parts. Okay. Now, if you look carefully here, I have not attached this line to this corner. This corner is not attached to this corner here. Okay. So, this part over here is called as hinge. This region is called as hinge region. Okay, now there are variable regions in antibody and constant regions in antibody. So this chain is called as heavy chain. Okay, these two chains are heavy chains and these are light chains. So these heavy chains are further divided into variable region and constant region. This region is variable, this is variable, and this is constant. So how are we going to name this? This is variable heavy chain region, VH. This is constant heavy chain region 1. This is the hinge region, we have already named it. This is constant heavy chain region 2, this is constant heavy chain region 3. Likewise, these are also named the same. This is also named in the same manner. Now this is light chain, okay? It is also subdivided into two parts. So this is a variable region in light chain, so we are going to name it as VL, L for light. And this is the constant region. When we are talking about antibody, we know that it is immunoglobulin. So it is protein structure. So it is going to have one end of amino group and another end is going to be acidic group. Okay. So here is the amine group. It is NH3 group. Here also it is NH3 plus. When we are saying 3, we have to write plus. If it is NH2, then there is no need to write plus. So these are the end terminals of this structure, and this is the C terminal, C double bond O, O minus, C double bond O, O minus. So this is the C end. For this chain, here is the CN, COO minus, COO minus, COO minus means C double bond O, O minus. So each heavy chain, that is the dark blue, and the light blue, that is light chain, in an immunoglobulin molecule, that means an antibody, contains an amino terminal, okay? Amino terminal variable region. This region is variable. It is going to vary. It is the variable region that consists of 100 to 110 amino acids that differ from one antibody to the next. The remainder, okay, this constant region, the remainder of each chain in the molecule, the constant C region, exhibits limited variation that defines two light chain subtypes. So in each light chain, there are two subtypes. So what are the subtypes of the light chain? It is kappa or lambda. In light chain, so this is the light chain, there are two variations, kappa or lambda. And in heavy chain, there are 5 subclasses. Okay, in heavy chain, this is the heavy chain. There are 5 subclasses. Which 5 subclasses? Mu, gamma, alpha, delta, or epsilon. So heavy chain will either be one of these 5, light chain is going to be either of these 2. So as you can see over here, there is a hinge. Okay, so this hinge is only present when in this heavy chains it is either gamma, delta or alpha, then there is going to be a proline rich hinge. Proline is an amino acid that is going to make it bend. It gives the structure a kink. That is why there is a hinge region, because it is rich in proline. But if it is mu or epsilon, then there will be no hinge region. Okay, and this variable region is going to be antigen binding region. Okay, this we are going to call as antigen binding region. All the variable regions are antigen binding region, and the constant region we are going to call it as effector activity. Now you might think that how these two proteins that are present are not connected to each other. So they are connected to each other between disulfide bonds. Okay, they are connected to each other by disulfide bond, SS bond. Okay, so these disulfide bonds are going to connect these two different chains. They are also available, or they are also present within the same chain also. Okay, in this constant region, suppose one sulfhydryl group, that is SH group, is coming out from one amino acid, and one SH group is coming out from another amino acid, so they can also get connected over here. So there are many disulfide bonds present. Okay, these are called as disulfide bonds. Okay, now I have drawn all the disulfide bonds over here, which are intramolecule. Now these two chains are also attached to each other with the help of disulfide bonds over here. Okay, so this is the very basic structure of antibody. This is the Y-shaped structure. Here there are hinges present. Because of what there are hinges? Because of the proline rich. There are going to be hinges, because if you look at the structure of the proline, it is going to give it a kink. It is going to help it bend. So the N-terminal regions are going to be variable regions. It is going to be different. It is not going to be constant. It is going to vary from molecule to molecule. It is very obvious that it should vary, because it is going to go and bind to the antigen. So depending on antigen, it should have a particular region to go and bind to the antigen, right? We have studied epitope and paratope. So what is epitope? It is the structure of the antigen which is going to go and bind to the paratope of the antibody. Okay, so it is never going to be constant. It has to be different for each and every antibody. But this has got less variation, we can say. Okay, These regions are called as constant regions, but with less variation.